I'm going to show an example of how to use Mathematica to solve ordinary differential equations. And I'm going to pick a particularly simple example and just show the bare bones approach. And then the subsequent screencasts will add in some of the details to make graphs look nicer and add in comments. But we're looking at a constant density isothermal batch reactor and the reaction second order. We're given initial conditions. We can write down the mass balances for this system, which are differential equations. The change in the concentration of A is the rate constant times the concentration of A and the concentration of B. And then the change in concentration of B is pretty similar, except we have a stoichiometric coefficient of 2. The initial conditions then is that Ca0 is 10 and Cb0 is 12. And the only other information we need for the solution is the rate constant, 0.1. I purposely not used units in this calculation to simplify as much as possible, because what we want to concentrate on is how to write the Mathematica program to solve these two simultaneous differential equations. To solve the differential equations in Mathematica, I've gone to File, New, and opened a notebook, and then I'm going to type in an equation that says my solution to differential equation is obtained using the NDSolve function that's built into Mathematica, and it's important that ND and S are capitalized. And then we need square brackets that contain the various parameters, including the equation. I need to include the equation now in these, what I'll call squiggly brackets. I'm going to write the first equation. Ca is my dependent variable for concentration. All my dependent variables have to indicate the independent variable in brackets. In this case, it's T. And then I need to use double equal signs in these equations. And then I can type in using star for multiplication. And again, when I write Ca, and likewise when I write Cb, I need to indicate the dependent variables. Put a comma. I'm going to hit enter here just to put the next equation on a different line. And I've left one important part out. Prime indicates this is a derivative, so the left side now is the derivative concentration of A respect to time. And then I have essentially the same type equation for B. So here's the equation for B. The only difference is we have a stoichiometric coefficient of 2 here. Again, a comma. A new line where I'm going to indicate the initial condition. This is A evaluated at time equals 0, double equal signs, value of 10, and then likewise B evaluated at 0, with brackets to indicate that, a double equal sign, and a value of 12. And so now I've entered the equations, including initial conditions, within these squarely brackets. I need a comma here. And I'm going to use enter again to make it clear. Any list needs to be in the squiggly brackets. And here I'm listing my dependent variables, Ca and Cb, a comma, and then again another list where I'm going to list my dependent variable, the initial time, and the final time that I want to do the integrations. Now I have everything I need to solve this differential equation. I'm going to put a semicolon here to indicate we're not going to do the calculation yet. And what we want to do is plot the output, and the function is named plot. Again, square brackets are needed. And again, a list within square brackets of what variables I'm plotting. In this case, I'm going to plot Ca and Cb. And so I use a comma to separate them. I have to indicate the independent variable. And then the notation in Mathematica to refer to the data is as follows: a slash, a period, and now the name of the equation that I'm plotting, followed by a comma. Again, a list that says t is my independent variable, and I want to plot it from 0 to 5. And if I want now Mathematica to do the calculations, I use shift enter. And here's the output from shift enter. It's plotting concentration versus time. I did not put in any of the options to label the x and y axis, make the graphs look nicer. Just the very basics to show how to solve more than one differential equation simultaneously using Mathematica. Again, an initial value problem for ordinary differential equations.